Aloe vera is a gorgeous wonder plant, can be easily grown indoors as well as outdoors. Given the proper plant care, these amazing aloe vera plants can live for many, many years. In this episode, we look into some important care tips, do's and don'ts, and some simple tricks for automatic multiplication, that is propagation of aloe vera plant. This video is a complete guide to aloe vera plant care and covers basic information on aloe vera plant benefits, important tips for growing aloe vera plant, how often to water aloe vera, how much sun does an aloe vera plant need, the best potting soil for aloe vera plants, best fertilizer for aloe vera plants, then propagating aloe vera plants. The timestamps for these topics are given in the description. You can simply click on these timestamps to directly go to that particular topic. But I request you to watch this video from start till end. And also, this video is requested by many of our dear viewers. Special mention and dedication to Mr. Ayub Mirza, Mrs. Rani Victor, Mr. Som Tandon, and many others. Well, let's begin with the basic information on aloe vera. Aloe vera is basically a cactus-like succulent plant, and this is just one of the hundreds of different types of aloe plants, and this is the most common type and commonly called medicinal aloe vera. Aloe vera is a stemless or very short-stemmed plant and can grow up to 100 cm tall. It's either grown as an ornamental plant for its beautiful look or as a medicinal plant to extract aloe vera gel from its fleshy leaves. Then aloe vera plant benefits. We'll not go into the details of this topic. To mention a few, most people are already very much familiar with the medicinal and healing properties of aloe vera plants. These days you'll find aloe vera gel in everything from skin and hair care products to drinks, supplements and even food products. Another great benefit of growing aloe vera plant as a house plant is that it helps to purify the air in our homes. I've discussed about NASA recommended air purifier plants in a detailed episode. You can check that from a link at top right corner of the screen or from the description below. Then aloe vera plant care tips. There's really not much to it, and guess what? Aloe vera plant might just do better if you ignore it. Yes, they thrive on neglect, but still there are a few things you need to do to keep your aloe vera plant growing and multiplying at its best. The two most important parts of this aloe vera plant care tips are proper watering and lighting. Then how often do you water aloe vera? The most common mistake people make when it comes to aloe vera plant care is overwatering. You know, aloes normally grow in desert climates where there is hardly any rain. Aloe veras are succulent plants and hold water in their leaves, so they can go a very long time without water. Overwatering will cause root rot and eventually cause the stem of the plant to rot, eventually killing the whole plant from the bottom up. Aloe vera plants like to be watered more during the summer days than the winter months. It's best to allow the soil to dry out completely before watering. The best method to water aloe vera is using the finger dip method. Dip 1 inch of the finger into the soil to check for moisture. Water it if it's completely dry. And when you water it, do it thoroughly, allowing all the excess water to run out of the bottom drainage holes. So the point to remember is thorough and infrequent watering is the rule for aloe vera and all other succulents and cacti. Then how much sun does an aloe vera plant need? The second most important thing about aloe vera plant care is proper lighting. Aloe vera plants will grow their best when given lots of light. Outdoors, aloe vera can be grown anywhere from full sun to partial shade. They tolerate any amount of light, but it's better to avoid direct noon sunlight. When it comes to shade and indoors, they generally tend to get leggy if they do not receive adequate sunlight. They also do very well under LED grow lights if they're grown indoors. If you do not have enough sunlight in your home, then you should definitely get a grow light for your aloe vera plant. You can check details on these topics on indoor plants, grow lights and things like that from a playlist linked at the top right corner of the screen and also in the description below. Then best potting mix for aloe vera plants. The best soil or the potting mix for aloe vera is one that drains very quickly and does not hold water. You can either use commercially available succulents and cacti mixes, or you can prepare your own DIY succulent soil mix. One such recipe I use is any good quality garden soil, roughly about 30 to 40%. Then sand. You can use river sand or the construction sand and not the sea or the beach sand for this, because it's high in sodium chloride, that is salt. The proportion to use is about 30 to 40%. You can also use cocoa peat or peat moss instead of sand for aloe vera, but generally it's not recommended for succulent plants because it retains a lot of moisture and some succulents have a risk of rot. Then thirdly, gravel chips or pebbles or even small marble or granite chips. This can be roughly about 10%. Then compost. This is actually not required for succulents because the natural habitats of most succulents and cacti is desert. But still, adding about 10% of compost like vermicompost or leaf compost or even decomposed cow dung powder. Also consider adding about 5 to 10% of neem cake powder. That's really effective in preventing rot from fungus and other harmful pathogens. Then the fifth component can be perlite or a mixture of perlite plus charcoal like wood charcoal pieces, that is biochar pieces. These ingredients keep the soil very loose and well aerated. Charcoal has some antifungal properties and hence it prevents root rot. All these mixed to about 10% can be added to the recipe. Then the seventh point is fertilizer for aloe vera. Aloe vera plants do not really need to be fertilized, but like most plants, they'll certainly benefit from being fed once in a while, especially during their active growing season like spring through summer. I recommend using organic plant fertilizer on your aloe vera plants rather than using the chemical stuff, especially if you plan to harvest and use the gel. Compost like vermicompost or decomposed cow dung powder, a handful of it once in a month is more than sufficient for aloe vera plants. And this can also help to encourage flowers in aloe vera plants. Then the last point is on propagation of aloe vera plants. The mother aloe vera plant will grow offsets, also known as aloe vera pups, that is around the base of the plant. And these babies can be carefully removed from the mother plant and potted on their own to create a new plant. It's easy as that. But how do you encourage production of more babies or offsets from the mother plant? Simple trick or solution to this is using a white container for growing the future mother plant. Plant this at the center of this container and you should see a lot of offsets coming soon. Aloe vera roots do not grow too deep and hence shallow, wider containers are preferred when you're repotting. Then you can also grow aloe vera from seeds. The mature aloe vera plant produces flowering once in a while. This mother plant produces flowers once in a year, but you need to provide full sunlight to induce flowering. You can collect its seed pods and then grow new aloe vera plants from its seeds. Then, can you grow aloe vera from a single leaf or leaf cuttings? I've tried this many times, but was completely unsuccessful. Please let me know in the comment box below if you have rooted an aloe vera from a leaf. So there you have it folks, please hit a thumbs up if you found this video helpful. Also share this video with your friends, comment below with your feedback and queries. Consider subscribing along with the bell notification. Happy gardening!